visitors come to NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida, iconic facilities such as the Mammoth Vehicle Assembly Building and Oceanside Launch Pads leave lasting impressions. Another facility that has had a long-standing impact on America's human spaceflight programs recently was renamed in honor of astronaut Neil Armstrong, who has been hailed as one of the greatest heroes of America's efforts to explore.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Originally constructed as the Manned Spacecraft Operations Building, the facility was renamed the Operations and Checkout, or O&C Building, prior to the start of the Space Shuttle program. On January 21, 2000, the O&C was added to the U.S. National Register of Historic Places. The O&C was dedicated as the Neil Armstrong Operations and Checkout Building in ceremonies on July 21st. NASA Administrator Charles Bolden, Kennedy's Director Bob Cabana, Apollo 11 crewmates Mike Collins and Buzz Aldrin, along with astronaut Jim Lovell and members of the Armstrong family were on hand for the event.
It's altogether fitting that today we rename this facility the Neil Armstrong Operations and Checkout Building. He, along with his crewmates, Buzz Aldrin and Michael Collins, are a bridge from NASA's historic journey to the moon 45 years ago to our path to Mars today.
I can't think of anybody better whose name could be on it than Neil Armstrong. Neil was one of the finest gentlemen I've ever known, a superb engineering test pilot.
The date coincided with the 45th anniversary of Armstrong and Aldrin completing the first exploration of the lunar surface.
After Apollo 8, specifically, when questioned, asked if he wanted me to go with him, and he said yes, and I will be ever, ever grateful.
And lifting off the moon to rendezvous with Collins in the command module for the trip home to Earth.
I think we all remember Neil's one small step. He took the process one step further. Again, that powerful, powerful combination of curiosity and intelligence propelled him to the top of his profession. Over and over again, he took it one step further, and that eventually brought him to the last rung on the ladder of the Apollo 11 limb.
Neil Armstrong was a close friend and an icon that I think represented the best in America.
A former naval aviator, Armstrong flew the X-15 rocket-powered aircraft seven times between 1960 and 1962. After being selected as a NASA astronaut, Armstrong served as a command pilot for Gemini 8 in 1966, the first spacecraft to dock with another orbiting vehicle. In 1969, he became the first person to walk on the moon as commander of Apollo 11. Armstrong's last visit to Kennedy took place in April of 2012, when he had an opportunity to try out the commander's seat of Space Shuttle Atlantis. He died 4 months later at the age of 82. Today, the Neil Armstrong O&C Building's high bay is the site where the agency's Orion spacecraft is being assembled. Orion is designed to take humans farther than they've ever gone before. Orion is now being assembled into a flight-ready spacecraft for the unpiloted Exploration Flight Test 1 atop a Delta IV rocket slated for December 2014. In the future, Orion will launch on NASA's new heavy-lift rocket, the Space Launch System. More powerful than any rocket ever built, SLS will be capable of sending humans to deep space destinations such as an asteroid and Mars. It's possible that the first person to put boots on the red planet will fly there in a spacecraft assembled in the building named for the first man to walk on the moon, Neil Armstrong.